Before I get started with my video, I wanna ask everyone who is watching to please, please, please pray for my parents. They both were tested positive for COVID. They are doing okay, but it will be a process. So I believe in God, and I believe that the more prayers we give, the more God will hear us. So please pray for my parents. Easy uploaded a video on Young Easy Vlogs. This video is called Addressing the Truth on How She Really Feels. Must watch. I know lately I've been doing a lot of Easy and Natalie videos, but come on now. It's entertaining. So wherever the entertainment is where I'm going. Y'all ready to watch? Let's get it.
So y'all have really been asking, like, yo, what has been going on with you and Natalie? I can be an emotional person sometimes, and how I feel about Natalie is like, what's up, Easy?
What's
gang? How are you guys doing? Yo, I kind of want to get straight to this video.
Okay, she's already starting off with low energy, so this is supposed to be serious. But let's see what she has to say.
I think it's a topic that you guys wanted to, you know, hear, or you guys had a lot of questions. You guys want to know what is actually going on. So, you know, I'm here to discuss it today. You know what I'm saying? We've been trying to keep it as real as possible and
let's
fill
talk.
You guys in so you don't feel left out. So let's get straight into this video. If you're new, welcome to my channel. I'm Young Easy. Hit that subscribe button. Welcome, welcome. Even if you aren't new and you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button. Go follow me on my Instagram.
Do the same for my channel, please. Subscribe, like, comment, and share all my videos, please. Because I'm all right.
Funny ass videos over there, totally different content, you know, and I'm shouting people out, so go over there and select. But let's get right into this topic, y'all. Let's get right into it. There we go. All right, let's get it popping. What's up, y'all? So first off, I want to say, like, yo, I've been kind of MIA on social media. Like, I haven't really been on social media.
Okay, so she has a smile on her face, so that's good. And she still has that best friend ring on. So what's going on?
Since this whole coming out story, like I used to, or like I usually am, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like to see the things that are popping up on my timeline and the questions that you guys have and like the stuff that I'm going through behind the scenes, it's just so much to process. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
It's just so much. And for the people that are just now subscribing or just seeing my face to catch you up, I recently expressed my love to one of my best friends of three.
Oh, hell no. I thought I took his toy away. He must have found another one. That's my dog. Give me a second. Oh, my God. All right, let's get back to it.
And mind you, she's straight. She's never been with a girl before. And I just had to tell her how I felt. You know, and I was deeply in love with her. And I just had to tell her. So when I told her, you know, it was very emotional. I was going through these emotions of fear and I was scared and I feared rejection, you know, but I just wanted it to be known because the audience started to see it and I started to feel it and I was just felt like I was hiding my feelings. So I expressed my love and that was a whole roller coaster of emotions. And thankfully, my best friend was in love with me too. So that's pretty much what's going on. And that's what's been going on for the past 2 weeks now.
Okay.
And yo, I just want to say all of the support that I'm getting, it's incredible. You know, I was scared to put this out. That was one of my most vulnerable videos. And it's just like, yo, it's freaking awesome. It's cool. I just didn't think that I had so much love and so much support from you guys. So I just want to say thank you guys for watching my story. And a lot of people have said that my story has helped them come out to their families, has helped them come out to the people that they've been in love with for so long. So I just want to say thank you for that. And
that's always a plus, having a YouTube channel and a platform. I know that we are helping at least one person in some way. To all my OG supporters, y'all know why I started this channel. I believe that everyone has a voice and that everyone should always speak their mind, state their opinion, respectfully of course, but never stay quiet out of fear because what you say matters. Especially with my mental health videos, I really hope that I'm touching someone's life.
Do appreciate all the love and support. Through these videos, you guys like, you guys see what we allow you to see. I have another channel called Easy X Natalie, and this channel, Young Easy Vlogs, and my Instagram and stuff like that. But of course, there's a lot of stuff that goes on behind the scenes, you know? And it's not like, oh, there's cameras around us 24/7. You're gonna see every single thing. So this is an explanation to why, like, you know, I haven't been on YouTube and stuff like that, because there's a lot of stuff that's going on behind the scenes. And I just want to address some of the things that you guys had questions about, you know? All right. A lot of people wonder or ask, or people that have already been subscribed and stuff like that. I just been seeing a lot of positive stuff, but also seeing a lot of negative stuff. I can be an emotional person sometimes, and it's just like, doing this for so many years, being in the social media light, it's like I had to program my mind to try to block out the negativity.
Just definitely. I try to train my mind to let it go in one ear and out the other, and for it to not affect me, because my channel is based on speaking your thoughts and your opinions. So who am I to tell someone who's speaking negatively to not speak up? At the same time, I have to learn not to let it affect me, because this person doesn't know me. By the end of the day, this person does not know me. It's a skill that you have to learn. And I'm learning.
Focus on the positive, because sometimes I found myself in a depressing state to where it was just like, why do they think that about me? Why are they being so cruel? If I was in person making this video, would they say that to my face? You know, and it's just like, so many people can be so hurtful. But, you know, regardless, I wanted to address people saying the videos that I have been the most vulnerable in, expressing my love to somebody that I wouldn't know if they would receive it the way I wanted them to. A lot of people think that was fake, you know, and a lot of people have said some negative stuff, and even just being disrespectful and rude. So I just kind of want to address that. Like, those are my 100% real, genuine feelings towards, you know, my—
Oh, Easy, I believe you. I hope you watch my videos, Easy, and I hope you are subscribed to my channel, because a few people are subscribed to my channel that are in the YouTube community. The YouTubers that I've reacted to have also commented on my videos, so I'm thankful for that. So Easy, Natalie, please watch my videos. I am a spectator. I'm not there to really witness your life. I'm only going off of the videos you guys post. So I'm gonna be honest with my thoughts. You having feelings for Natalie, Natalie having feelings for you, I believe that is true. I believe that is real. It's just this storyline that you guys are having, this little series, is throwing me off. I think a lot of it is scripted, and there's nothing wrong with that. You guys are just trying to entertain us. It's also a business. Why not? You know, why the fuck not? I'm not hating on you with that. Do what you gotta do. But I wanna know what's real and what's not. You know what I mean? But your feelings towards each other, oh, 100% is real. I ain't denying that.
Best friend. And it's like, some of that stuff could get to me, to where it's like seeing a lot of people's comments, even on other people's videos and stuff like that. That stuff was kind of like getting to me a lot. And it was just like, you know, I was trying not to feed into it, because I know people control. But what are you going to do? You can't fight them through a screen. You know what I'm saying? So,
and this is the thing too, Easy. I'm a reactor. I react to videos. If I say something that comes off as negative, I'm not here literally thinking negatively about this YouTuber throughout the day, every day. I'm literally just filming, reacting, and then I turn off the camera. Then I go on about my day. And because I am on this side, I realize to myself, okay, so these negative people in my comments speaking so badly about me, after they left their comment, I'm 100% sure that they went off to live their life freely and not even thinking about me at all. I realize that it's just for fun, just to poke fun up at people at that moment. And as for me, it's entertainment purposes only. This isn't to make anyone feel bad, because I don't believe in bullying. So Easy, the videos that you watch from people, the comments that you're reading, don't let it affect you. Keep on living your life, you know? Only you and Natalie know.
It's like a lot of stuff that kind of like, you know, triggered my emotions seeing comments and stuff like that. So I just wanted to address that. Like, people think that, oh, like, I'm putting on these fake ass tears for, you know, money. Yeah, and it's just like, yo, like, no. Throughout the years, I learned to not be emotional. You know what I'm saying? And have thick skin and have to toughen up my skin, because if I did, I wasn't gonna last in this game. you know, but I can be an emotional person. Mm-hmm. So seeing that stuff, I feel like anybody can get emotional about it and stuff like that. It's just how you deal with it. And a lot of things that I was, how I was dealing with it, it was just like, you know, but that was my genuine feelings towards Natalie. Those were real emotions. So to anybody that thinks that that was fake, I don't owe you anything, but you know, I still want to be expressive, and I want to make this video.
Okay.
So y'all have really been asking, like, yo, what has been going on with you and Natalie? Just to break it down, and people were saying that it was fake because it was just like how it was broken up, you know, and I just wanted to address that. If you watch the video, like the first two videos of me expressing my love to Natalie was all in the same day. It was just split into two videos. And her response, I gave her what? I think I gave her like a couple days to just respond and really think about what I said. So in reality, those videos that were broken up, it was literally within 3 days. When you express your love to somebody, you can't instantly rush them. People are like, well, why wouldn't they make it in one video, blah, blah, blah. It's like, this is...
Of course. And girl, I'm telling you, most likely these are just kids. These are kids that don't know how life really is, how love really works, how maturity presents itself. They just don't know, you know?
Life, real feelings. Like, I'm not about to rush her feelings, you know? So it was just like seeing the comments and stuff like that. Some of the comments, it was just like getting to me, you know? And there's a lot of positive videos, but there's also a lot of hate videos. Like, oh, this is fake. Like, they're just doing it to get their money. They're doing this to promote their book and yada, yada, yada. Before I expressed my love, there was promotion for the book, you know? Before I expressed my love. It's like, of course, this is excitement. We just got a book sale. Of course, I'm gonna say that. So why not still promote the book? I'm gonna promote my book, whether I'm sad, whether I'm happy, whether I'm in love, whether I'm being expressive. I'm gonna promote my book regardless. So it wasn't-
Regardless. Girl, do you. Do you. All right? Like I said, it's a business. Promote your book if you have to. And if you see me poking fun at it, it's okay. It's for fun. It's entertainment. Nothing else. Keep doing you. Keep promoting that book.
Big scheme to just promote our book. No. And I'm a real human being. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to address it so you guys understand. I really felt this way towards Natalie. You know, a lot of them haven't even watched our videos, haven't seen our chemistry and the friendship that has been built up for years.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So they're just judging us based off of when I expressed my love to Natalie till now. You know what I'm saying?
They've always had that connection. If y'all haven't caught up to their videos and y'all don't know, they've always had that connection. And a lot of the supporters have always wanted them together because we've all seen it. We see how they look at each other. This ain't no regular friendship. They're literally soulmates, and you can just see it.
Well, they didn't build this with us. You know what I'm saying? The people that been here, like y'all know, y'all understand, y'all get it. So to people that just are new here, you know, are new to my life and my story, to answer your question, the chemistry is real.
Chemistry is real.
Love. This isn't a fake story. So that's the answer to your question right there.
Believe it.
Just go watch watch our videos from 2017. You know what I'm saying? I've seen that y'all are saying like Natalie's not even really interested in me. Natalie doesn't really like girls. You know how I feel about Natalie? It's like I can understand why y'all would think that, especially her being straight and her, you know, those are my exact fears before I express my love to her. So I understand that you guys think that it's a possibility that she couldn't like me. But mind you, like I said, I had been feeling this way for a while, and I know Natalie like the back of my hand, bro. The thing that I thought with Natalie and why she wasn't being expressive to how she felt towards me was because it was like she had never been with a girl. And knowing her, I knew that that was going to be it. I also did think this regular thoughts that girls would probably have not ever dating a girl. You know, I feel like the videos after me expressing my love, Natalie, I know she loves me. And it's still her being shy. This is a totally different side. She's never experienced anything.
And that's a true statement. Natalie looks uncomfortable a lot. I don't deny Natalie having feelings for Easy. I think it's just the fact that not only have you learned that you actually have feelings for a girl, but you're doing it in front of the world. I just think where Easy fails is that she's being too pushy on her. She's pushing it too much, you know, in front of the camera. And who knows too, maybe Natalie is not into PDA, public display of affection. Maybe she ain't into all that. It's been years, you guys. They've both been single for like 4 years. And just doing it in front of a camera where millions of people are watching. You guys, it's a lot for Natalie. Let me tell you. Easy, you got it good right now. Natalie, she's got it rough. And that's why I say, Easy, take your time with her. Don't be so pushy. Let her get comfortable first.
You know, when it comes to us being best friends, it's 100% authentic. But when it comes to her exploring this side, I want you guys to understand, just like I have to understand, that this is new for her.
Right.
You know, it's not her just faking it and just doing it and she's uncomfortable doing it for a check or whatever. I know 100% she knows that she loves me. She wouldn't just do this for a check. She's true to herself. She's not gonna sell her soul and pretend to like women just for a check. No, that's just not her, okay? So let's talk about...
I'm glad you said all that, Easy, but I'd rather hear that stuff from Natalie. I want Natalie to speak to us and explain to us what she's going through and what she's feeling. What y'all think? Comment below. What y'all think?
This engagement. Are me and Natalie engaged?
No, y'all ain't engaged. No.
2017, I gave my best friend this ring. I gave my best friend a matching ring like this. And the ring was to symbolize friendship. I love to do sweet things. I'm just a giving person and I appreciated our friendship. So I decided to give us matching rings. So now, fast forward to the future that we're dating and stuff like that, it's like, are we engaged? And what sparked the question when Natalie lost her, you know, her ring? She lost her ring recently, not too long ago or whatever. A lot of people were saying that I had accidentally slipped up and I said engagement ring. You know, so a lot of everybody's hopping on it, like, yo, they've been engaged, I knew it, blah, 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 blah. So I did say that. I did. I slipped up and said engagement ring. Just to you know, get you guys' mindset exactly, pinpointing exactly what's going on. People were pointing out like she had been lost it. I didn't know when she lost it. Y'all are detectives. And this is why I love Neasy Gang supporters. The last time that our supporters said that they seen it is when we were in the jacuzzi doing the Touch My Body challenge. That's what they were saying, like the last time that they had seen it. So fast forward to... You know, when I found the ring or whatever in that video, I specifically said, I didn't even know I said engagement ring. I didn't even know. And it was just like...
Girl, it just came out naturally, huh? I think somebody wants to be engaged. I mean, I'm just saying.
Damn! Y'all watching, no TikTok. So to address the rumors about me and Natalie being engaged,
no,
I don't know if this is going
they're not.
To upset you guys. I don't know if this is going to make you guys
they're not
feel
engaged.
Like, damn, I wish they were engaged, but no, guys, we aren't engaged.
Far from it. They're far from it. Take it slow, y'all. Not all of us lesbians take it that fast. Some of us do. Some of us do, but not all of us.
The engagement ring, it was on accident. It was 100% on accident. You know, I'm talking fast. I just ran out the house trying to be sneaky. My goofy ass. Like, I'm not even thinking. I didn't say engagement ring on purpose. Anniversary engagement ring. It was on accident. So, sorry.
How did he... Oh, my God. This is the third time. How did he find another toy that squeaks? Hold on.
Like...
Oh, shit. Hold on. Give me a sec. Anyways.
Some hopes or whatever. Or upset you guys. Like, damn, I wish they was engaged. But... Me and Natalie are not engaged at all. I haven't been on social media and stuff like that because, like I said, there's been a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes that, you know, I haven't filmed and stuff like that. And you guys are asking, where has Natalie been? She's at her sister's house, I think. She's been going back and forth with her sister's house. So if you guys want to, you know, talk to her, she'll be on her channel and stuff like that. So, with that being said, I'm gonna keep posting videos on here, being
okay.
Active and
work.
Entertaining you guys and
hustle.
Stuff like that. So I'm excited to bring you guys content. Today is my best friend Danielle's birthday. Make sure you guys go to her Instagram, tell her happy birthday, tell her I sent you. I'm about to enjoy that with her, and yeah.
And that's how she ended the video. Okay, well, what do you guys think about my videos on this whole Easy and Natalie thing? I feel like I'm being entertaining, respectful, but I'm always gonna be honest whether anyone likes it or not. I've always thought their love is real, their chemistry is real. It's just this whole damn storyline that's pissing me off because I think these are real life situations but turned into skits, you get me? What do y'all think? Comment below, let me know what you think. All right, you guys, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe, and please hit that bell so you can get notified every time I upload. See you in the next video. Peace.